Welcome. Today's topic for discussion is Wi-Fi radio chains, spatial streams, and its notations. Let us understand few concepts before moving further. Single input, single output. SISO is where we have a single antenna at the transmitter, TX, and single antenna at the receiver, RX. Single input, multiple output. We can have multiple receive antennas. A single transmitted signal is received independently from two different branches, and this can be used to improve link reliability by combining those received versions of the signal. Simply saying, we get two or more radio links with the same information, thus when there is a big distortion, example, deep fade, on one link, the probability that the other is also bad is smaller. This is referred to as SIMO, single input multiple output. Multiple input single output. We have two or more copies of the signal transmitted to a single receive antenna, and by similar means as in SIMO, we improve the reliability of the signal radio link. The most common scheme for antenna transmit diversity is to use Alamudi encoding for assuring the orthogonality between the transmission streams transmitted from the two or more antennas. This is known as MISO, multiple input single output. Multiple input multiple output. MIMO is the final stage, when we have both multiple TX and RX antennas, and by this we could also improve link reliability, or do something else, that in other configurations is not possible, that is, transmit two or more in case of more antennas different data streams, to increase the overall system throughput, because in this case we transmit more data using the same time frequency resources, that is, the same bandwidth and time slots. Radio chains. 802.11n introduced the concept of MIMO to Wi-Fi networking. MIMO radios use multiple radio chains working in parallel to transmit twice as much data at a time as a single radio could do. You always want both chains in operation for the fastest rates. With just one chain, you're not doing MIMO, you're just doing traditional SISO, so you're not much better off than 802.11a, or 802.11g. ANG used 20 MHz wide channels and got a maximum PHY rate of 54 Mbps. If you use those same 20 MHz wide channels with 802.11n and limit yourself to SISO, your maximum PHY rate only goes up to 72.2 Mbps. This increase is only because 802.11n added a couple new higher rate modulation schemes than A or G had. But if you turn on both radio chains, you're doing 2x2:2 MIMO, your max PHY rate doubles to 144.4 Mbps. And it's not just the max PHY rate that doubles. The second radio chain doubles your set available rates. For each of the 8 single spatial stream rates, there is a 2 spatial stream rate that doubles it. Of course, 802.11n also allows you to double your channel width to 40 MHz. Doubling your channel width has the bonus of increased efficiency, so it actually slightly more than doubles your max PHY rate. So SISO 802.11n with 40 MHz channels can do 150 Mbps, and 2x2:2 MIMO 802.11n with 40 MHz channels can do 300 Mbps. The only time you'd want to disable a radio chain is if you were trying to do a long-distance outdoor link, and didn't have an antenna rig that could provide enough separation between your two radio or antenna chains. If you didn't want to have to mount twice as many antennas on your antenna masts at each end of the link, and have them spaced far enough apart that they don't interfere with each other, then you might opt for a SISO link for cost or simplicity's sake, even though it means only half the throughput, 150 Mbps max PHY rate instead of 300. Spatial streams. Spatial streaming is primarily observed in wireless communications where multiple input multiple output is being used. When wireless signals are being transmitted or received simultaneously in a MIMO environment, the signals being transmitted by the various antennae are multiplexed by using different spaces within the same spectral channel. These spaces are known as spatial streams. In a MIMO environment, multiple antennae are used, both at a receiving station and at a transmitting station. In order to transmit and receive various signals simultaneously, A common multiplexing technique known as spatial multiplexing is used. Basically, when wireless signals are being transmitted simultaneously from different antennae, each signal is transmitted via a spatial stream within the given spectral channel to avoid collisions. Notations: T cross R colon S. Where T is transmitter, R is receiver, S is spatial streams. How many SS an AP can transmit or receive depends on the last parameter in the T cross R colon S notation. If the S parameter is 2, it can send 2. However, if you have a 3 cross 3 colon 2 AP, it can send those 2 streams over all 3 radios. There are various reasons why you would have more radios than spatial streams, and vendors implement different features for that. Each radio has its own antenna. One thing to clearly remember and understand is that an AP is a hub, not a switch. It will send data packets to one station or another AP at a time, and it will expect an acknowledgement for each one. 802.11ac will change this a bit in the future. 11ac started with the MIMO idea, that will send packets to more than one station simultaneously, however it will require more than 4 radios to be of any use there. In the case of an iPhone, which is a 1x1:1 device, a 2x2:2 AP can send one stream only to it, however it can leverage all of its radios and send packets via all of its antennas. Why? Well, it can use beamforming. And it can also receive on all radios. This is what RW does that puts them miles above the rest. It has dual polarized antennas, one antenna is perpendicular to another, so it can receive signals that come from any direction and combine it positively. This is called polarization diversity. They claim it adds up to 4 dB of gain, which is big, and it helps with the speed of the link and especially with transmissions that might occur if the client is at an edge of a cell, for example, where another AP might fail because it doesn't have those 4 dB of help. It means the AP hears much, much better. Hope this video is useful. Please subscribe to Leo's Tech Talk to access a list of Wi-Fi videos and notified for future videos.